मैं आपका स्वागत करता हूँ आई रिस्पेक्ट यू आई वांट टू आई एम नॉट हियर टू क्रश विद यू और फाइट विद यू आई वांट टू ब्रेक यू थैंक यू आई नो यू हैव अंडरस्टूड मी आई स्पोक इन इंडियन उर्दू The only thing I want to ask you, one small question. First, you all say, Shirao, Pita, Magar, Suvar, Nahi, Kaka. My Hindu.
Beautiful.
What you said is that Christ lived for 1.5 days, according to what I read in the Bible during my school days, was he rose on the third day. He's there 3 days of the third day. He rose on the third day. And ascended into heaven. But according to Yohan, I'm British born, but I'm not Indian, born Indian. According to your country of origin, the people claim there that Christ lived there with them after rising for 15 years or something and built St. Thomas Church. Or enhanced it, I don't know. What sort of comments do you have, Dali?
No, you see, the Christian is not making an issue out of that. That Jesus went to India and he started the St. Thomas' Church. St. Thomas did the St. Thomas' Church. Why would Jesus go and create a St. Thomas' Church? He was created a St. Jesus' Church. Doesn't make sense. You see? But now, be as it may, our idea is that, look, nobody dies for your sins. Nobody carries your burden for you. You, according to the law of karma, what you do, you pay for. If you have done well, you earn a reward. If you have done evil, you pay the punishment. That is also Islam. You see, that we have to pay for our own sins. The soul that sinneth, it shall die. The one that sins will perish. The son shall not bear the iniquity of the father. The Bible says, son means father Adam. We will not pay for what Adam did. Poor Adam, he made a mistake and he paid the full price. He paid the full price. We, his children, will not be questioned. He says, your father Adam, you know what he did? So he, God punishes us for that. He says, no, he won't do that. Neither the son bear the iniquity of the father. The father shall not bear the iniquity of the son. Neither shall the son bear the iniquity of the father. God Almighty will not ask Adam. He says, look at your children. 25 million sodomites. You call them gays in America. Your children, the bloody rubbish. What kind of children have you brought? No. God will not ask Adam, and he will not ask us what Adam and Eve did. The soul that sinneth, it shall die. That is the law of God. But if the wicked will turn from all the sins that he has committed, means he asks for forgiveness and repents, and do that which is lawful and right, he shall surely live. He shall not die. That is Islam. That is Islam. You pay for your sins, I pay for mine. Nobody pays for anybody's sins. But the Christian believes that somebody must pay for his sins. So he wants to pass the buck on to Jesus. You know, make things easy for himself. He can do what he likes, but Christ paid for it. And Jimmy Swaggart, he said, the greater the sin, the greater the redemption. What kind of redemption is it? Jesus Christ. I stole somebody's pin. This pin. And Jesus pays for that. For my parking ticket, he pays for that. What has he done? But for Hitler's sins, on account of him, 40 million people died in the Second World War. If Jesus pays for that, that is something. If he pays for Peter Sutcliffe, he raped and ripped 13 women, and Jesus pays for that, that will be something. Get the idea? The greater the sin, the greater the redemption. What philosophy is this?